Welcome to the official weigh-in as we get set for a great night of championship boxing to be held tomorrow from the Copper Box Arena in London, England. It is all being brought to you by Frank Warren on behalf of Queensberry, along with their great sponsors, 32 Red, Unibet, and Hype Energy UK. This great event will be televised live on TNT Sports beginning at 7 p.m. London time and also in the United States on ESPN+. We are going to begin the weigh-in process. These two fighters competing tomorrow in a scheduled four-round international super featherweight contest. First, we will welcome to the scale a native of Colombia, now making his home in Venice, Italy. He brings a professional record consisting of 9 wins, 13 defeats, 4 draws, with 3 of his 9 wins coming by way of knockout. Let's welcome to the scale, Vin El Fantasma Aiceto.
Well, here comes Vin Caicedo. 22-year-old Colombian will provide the opposition tomorrow evening for Charlie Hickford. Classy Charlie Hickford, fight number 2 for him. Let's have a look at his opponent on the scales.
126.7 for Vin Caicedo.
Looks in good shape, Caicedo.
And now we welcome to the scale from Rochester, England, undefeated with 1 victory. Let's welcome Classy Charlie Hickford.
A nice ovation here for Charlie Hickford, who has some of the best hair I've ever seen in boxing.
Yep, great shape on the hair as well as the physique.
He had his pro debut. He was at York Hall. We went 4 rounds and not a hair was out of place. He says that's the aim on Saturday night once again.
127.4 for Charlie Hickford.
Yeah, looking confident. He's looking very confident there.
They call him Classy Charlie. This will be the second time he has a face-off as a professional with an opponent. 4-time national amateur champion, 2-time European medalist as well. He is classy.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, these two competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 4-round international super featherweight contest.
His opponent looks... Is it Caicedo?
Our next two Caicedo, fighters yeah. to the scale looks, competing looks, tomorrow looks night in a scheduled 4-round international lightweight contest. First, we will welcome to the scale a native of Nicaragua, now making his home in Bratislava, Slovakia. He brings a record of 33 professional bouts. Let's welcome Angel El Cohete Gomez.
Well, here's Angel Gomez, fight number 34 for the Nicaraguan, 24 years old now, living in Slovakia.
133.9 for Angel Gomez.
He's actually got a fight lined up next weekend as well.
Yeah. Now to the scale, from Upminster, London, England, his professional record, undefeated with 1 victory, here is Billy Boom Boom Adams.
Nice ovation here for Billy Boom Boom Adams, fight number 2. 4-time national amateur champion, senior ABA man, and ripped to shreds, Nathan.
Yeah, he's in good shape. It's like anything, being on these stages at such a early part of your career, very, very fortunate, but top amateur.
132.5 for Billy Adams.
He was on the podium squad for GB. Was going to go to the Olympics, but he couldn't make the weight anymore. Advised by Colin McMillan, former WBO world champion. Looks like a young man with a big future ahead of him, Nathan.
Absolutely. But these Nicaraguans are very, very tough. My first ever fight for on a Queensberry show was against a lad from that country. So, yeah, they're very, very tough.
They don't want to go down, do they?
No, absolutely not. Actually, did stop my.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, these two competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 4-round international lightweight contest.
But you're right, he didn't go down. I stopped him, but he didn't go down.
Stopped him. On his feet.
Yeah.
Referencing enough. It's a very stern look from Billy Boom Boom Adams. I think he enjoyed that.
Yeah.
Do you enjoy them?
Yeah.
Do you enjoy the face-offs?
I find the face-offs a bit
Our
weird.
Next two combatants to the scale competing tomorrow night in a scheduled four-round international middleweight contest. First, we welcome to the scale, coming to us from Chanov, Poland. He brings a record consisting of 7 wins, 13 defeats, 1 draw, 5 of his 7 wins coming by way of knockout. Let's welcome Bartosz Głowacki.
Well, here comes Bartosz Głowacki. Only ever been stopped once, and that was by another southpaw in Ben Fail. Very tough, very durable.
159.13 for Bartosz Głowacki.
Didn't he go the distance with Royston Barney-Smith as well?
He's been the distance
now to
George
the scale
Davey, Shaquille
from
Thompson.
Luton, Bedfordshire. Undefeated with one victory.
Different I'm thinking
Let's
different
welcome
different
Sam King.
I was going to say these are big lads.
Yeah, that's good.
He's not that big.
I don't think they'd let Royston Barney-Smith fight Bartosz Głowacki. But here is Sam King, middleweight in your division.
Yeah.
Have you moved about with
him? No. It's the first time I've seen him.
He's done a lot of time sparring Hamzah Sheeraz. He's based out of the Peacock Gym as well, so spars Denzel Bentley, the Fowl brothers. Fight number two for Sam King.
£160 for Sam King.
That's what I was talking about. At least big lad at middleweight.
Yeah, did very well as an amateur. 57 fights, 49 wins from those fights. And he's going around the gyms a little bit. I've seen him with Freddie Roach. I mean, he's based here in the Peacock with Martin Bowers, managed by Martin Bowers as well. But he's taken himself over to the States for months at a time and got in some hard rounds over there around Freddie Roach, around Hamzah Sheeraz as well in the Ten Goose. So he's learning his trade.
If you're doing that, going all over the world, it can only put you in good stead.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, these two competing tomorrow night in a scheduled four-round international middleweight contest.
The other people I've seen do that is the McKenna brothers. They go everywhere. Yeah, they spar everyone all over the world.
Very grounded man as well. You watch any of his interviews, speaks very well. Intelligent fighter, very well schooled. Plenty of ambition from Sam King in this sport.
Our next two combatants to the scale competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 6-round international featherweight contest. First, we welcome to the scale a native of Colombia, now making his home in Venice, Italy. His professional record, 10 wins, 14 defeats, 3 wins, coming by way of knockout. Let's welcome Michael El Mono Velasco.
Well, Michael Velasco, fight number 25 for the Colombian, seen recently on these shores against Royston Barney-Smith, actually, last time out.
129.2 for Michael Velasco.
Is that one for Macaulay Owen?
Now we welcome to the scale from Ilford, England, undefeated with
some of these boys
are
4-7, aren't they?
Yeah, they get around
four
here.
4-7. Omar Khan!
I'll tell you, I knew it was going to go off in here for Omar Khan. Always gets a great evasion, always brings plenty with him to the weigh-in. I'm sure he'll have plenty with him, of course, on Saturday night. It will be fight number 9 for Omar Khan.
128 pounds for Omar Khan.
Omar Khan is another fighter who's up sticks. He's gone over to Spain. Spain is
Malaga.
Where he's now. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's where he's learning his trade. Is it something you've ever considered, Nathan, just up in sticks, or have you always been that Stoke native?
Nah, I'm very lucky that one of the best coaches in the country is right in Stoke-on-Trent, so I'm very lucky. I can't imagine
Once
that.
Again,
can't imagine being away from my family.
Competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 6-round international featherweight contest.
Yeah, because I think I saw something about... Was it Trannery box previously?
Yeah.
And obviously his... the Malaga camp with picking him to beat Khan. I think he's given a bit of motivation to do that. So
yeah, well, they've certainly upped his level of opposition. Yeah. They are becoming sterner and sterner tests, and coming through someone like Kevin Trano in style the way he did was a bit of a statement actually from Umar Khan, and he's heading the right way. Hamzah Sheeraz's cousin, of course, as well.
Okay.
Our next fighter to the scale competing tomorrow in a scheduled 6-round international cruiserweight contest. His opponent, Miroslav Savic, will weigh in at a later time. Let's welcome from Penge, London, England, his professional record, 5 wins, just 1 defeat, all 5 wins. Coming by way of knockout, here is Alois the Animal Junior.
Well, it's fight number 7 for the 20-year-old they call the Animal, and you can see why, Nathan.
He's in fantastic shape. You can see why he's going for his 6th consecutive knockout to this one.
This would be, yeah.
I remember him coming on the scene when he...
204.13 for Alois Jr.
He boxed Michael Soshensky on his pro debut. Yeah. And Soshensky is not the kind of guy you just take on your debut. He did it.
I think he got dropped in that fight, didn't he? If he hadn't dropped, he probably would possibly would have won.
I mean, he was 18 years old when he took that fight. He got dropped. I think he was very, very cold heading into the ring. But the fact that he was in there and he was swinging it out said a lot about him.
Competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 6-round international cruiserweight contest. First, we will welcome from Cadiz, Andalusia, Spain. He has 26 professional bouts to his credit. Let's welcome Alvaro Tenero.
I think the best thing about it though as well, it's just shown he hasn't been penalised for taking a risk so early on in his career. Yeah, Frank's exactly looking after him. Frank's still putting him on the big shows and progressing him along.
Well, it was after that, if we're talking about Alois Jr., it was after that loss that he got offered a brilliant contract, a long contract with Frank Warren as well. So he sort of earned his stripes in defeat. So you can take risks as a fighter.
204.13 for Alvaro Terrero.
Terrero is the man charged with taking on Tommy Fletcher.
Now to the scale from Norfolk, England, undefeated with 6 wins. 5 of his 6 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is Tommy, the Norfolk Nightmare Fletcher.
Simply one of the best nicknames in all of boxing, the Norfolk Nightmare. How about that, Nathan?
Yes, fantastic name.
Punches very, very hard. He's a 6'7" cruiserweight. Really, I mean, he's boxing essentially a heavyweight tomorrow. The guy he's boxing has taken on Johnny Fisher, Sol Dacres, people like that. If he's able to get him out of there, it says a lot about his power.
202.5 for Tommy Fletcher.
I saw him box, I'm sure it was on the BFBF card with Yard.
Yeah.
Where he boxed Darryl Sharp.
Yes.
No, Darryl Sharp, I boxed him on my debut. And Darryl Sharp's a very, very tough man. Southport.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, these two competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 6-round international cruiserweight contest.
Darryl Sharp, who you mentioned there, is the only man that's taken Tommy Fletcher the distance. Nobody else has gone the distance with this guy. He seems to hit very, very hard. Mark Tibbs likens him to a bit of a Deontay Wilder. He has got that sort of gangly frame.
We saw one of the fights where he threw an uppercut and completely laid the guy out.
Phenomenal. Our next two combatants to the scale competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 8-round international light heavyweight contest. First, we welcome to the scale, coming to us from Ascoli Piceno Marche, Italy. He is undefeated with 10 wins, 1 draw, 2 of his 10 wins, coming by way of knockout. Let's welcome Eros Segetti.
Well, here is the man who will be taking on Carol Itauma tomorrow evening, Eros Segetti. Unbeaten in 11
182.3 for Eros Segetti. Now we welcome to the scale from Chatham, Kent, England, his professional record, 11 wins, just 1 defeat, 7 of his 11 wins coming by way of knockout. Let's welcome Carol Itauma.
Great ovation here for the Olympic youth gold medalist Carol Itauma. Just 23 years old. Unbeaten opponent. He is a baby.
He's a baby. 23.
181.12 for Carol Itauma.
I actually sparred the Italian Brothers' head coach, Dan Woolidge, years ago. I think it was at St Mary's in Chatham.
Yes, of course,
yeah.
Good gym, good place, Chatham.
Yeah, not bad.
Carol Itauma, of course, is the older brother of Moses Itauma. Clearly great genetics, great fighting men.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, these two competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 8-round international light heavyweight contest.
He's had a couple of good wins since, obviously, again, I think he was on the BTBF card.
Yes, he was. He suffered that one upset defeat, but he's bounced back with two wins. He'll be looking to get another win tomorrow evening. He's a very focused, very concentrated character, very serious guy, Carol Itauma. Big ambitions in the sport for both of the Itauma brothers.
Very, very talented.
Our next two combatants to the scale competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 10-round international light heavyweight contest. First, we welcome to the scale, coming to us from Belgrade, Serbia. He brings a professional record consisting of 32 wins, 3 defeats, with 12 wins, coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Marko Nikolic.
Well, it's fight number 36 for the man from Serbia, tasked with essentially ruining Anthony Yard's 2024. If he's able to pull off the upset tomorrow evening, it will be a bit of an upset. It will be a real shock. I was looking at his Instagram. He said that he's aware that Yard is bigger, Yard is stronger, but he says that he has a crazy head and he won't give up.
179.6 for Marko Nikolic.
No, it's going to be a very very tough. But Yard, like I said,
and now we welcome to the scale from Ilford, England. His professional record consists of 24 wins, 3 defeats. 23 of his 24 wins coming by way of knockout. Let's welcome the former two-time world title challenger, Anthony the Beast from the East, Yard.
Here is the man, Anthony Beast from the East, Yard, who has clearly established himself now as one of the very best light heavyweights in the world.
177.7 for Anthony Yard.
Always in great shape, always.
Always in tremendous shape. And this is fight number 28 for him as a pro. He only had 12 as an amateur. When you add all of that up, that's 40 fights all together. That's unbelievable in terms of how far he's come.
Phenomenal. Like, you don't usually get to that level without somebody having some kind of pedigree behind you, particularly in the amateur scene. So he's done phenomenally well.
It's almost like he has no right to be where he is, to have challenged for a world title twice. And you look at other fighters with much more amateur pedigree, and they're not doing what he's doing.
Well, look at Callum Smith. Callum Smith, the amateur pedigree that man had, as well as his family's pedigree throughout the boxing, in Yard put on a performance against Bertabiev that wasn't matched by someone of Callum's pedigree.
There's been a lot of talk about a potential future fight.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, these two competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 10-round international light heavyweight contest.
A lot of talk about a potential future fight with Joshua Buatsi, who we understand will be in attendance on Saturday night, but Marko Nikolic looks game, looks up for it, and here's the man very much in Anthony Yard's way. That was a pretty serious face off.
Yeah. Is this? Yeah. I think Yard's cool.
Our next two combatants to the scale competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 10-round contest, and it will be for the Commonwealth Silver Featherweight Championship. First, we will welcome to the scale the challenger from Leeds, Yorkshire, England. He was a 2016 Olympian and now is a professional, has a record consisting of 12 wins, 2 defeats, 5 of his 12 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the former WBA Continental Super Bantamweight Champion, Cass Ashfaq.
Well, here's Cass Ashfaq, representing Great Britain at the Olympics. Did plenty as an amateur. Now a big opportunity as a pro to upset Masood Abdullah, who is unbeaten.
125.13 for Cass Ashfan. And now we welcome to the scale the defending champion from Islington, London, England. He is undefeated with 9 wins, 6 of his 9 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the reigning and defending Commonwealth silver featherweight champion, Masood Abdullah.
Well, here comes Super Mass. And he'll need to be at his super best.
125.7 for Masood Abdullah.
Feast to come through against Kez Ashfaq. Looks like a stern test. Last time out, he beat Mark Leach. He stopped Mark Leach. First man to do that. It was very impressive. As we know, Mark Leach is a tough guy.
Very, very good. Very good fights as well. I think he's under, obviously, Jamie Niles and Travis up in Manchester, Salford way. And in the based on previous performances of Mark Leach, he was very, very good. So for him to do that against Mark Leach, obviously Liam Davis also beat Mark Leach as well, but still.
Yeah, it was a bit very, of a statement. Bit of a statement from Masood Abdullah, Commonwealth Silver Featherweight Championship on the line. And I'm interested with this face-off because the press conference was pretty spiky.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, these two competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 10-round contest for the Commonwealth Silver Featherweight Championship.
Yeah, it did kick off a little bit at the press conference yesterday. Masood had plenty to say. Kez Ashfaq was firing back as well.
Ashfaq's been on that domestic scene, though. Is an amateur and international scene. Yeah. So he knows he's got the pedigree there to cause an upset.
Yeah, it's exactly that. The losses that he had, he contests them. He doesn't think he did lose those fights. Masood Abdullah has looked perfect so far as a pro. Very intriguing fight at featherweight.
Our next two combatants to the scale, competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 12-round contest. It will be for the Commonwealth WBC International Silver Vacant British and Vacant WBO International Silver Lightweight Championships. First to the scale, the challenger from Hull, England, undefeated with 13 wins, 4 wins, coming by way of knockout. He is the current English lightweight champion. Let's welcome Lewis, the thrill from Gypsyville, Sylvester.
Well, here's Lewis Sylvester. He's the English champion, unbeaten so far in 13 fights. He provides the opposition to Sam Noakes vacant British title amongst many other titles on the line tomorrow night.
134.13 for Lewis Sylvester.
And now we welcome pain to as well the with them scale, tattoos.
The defending champion from Maidstone, Kent, England. Undefeated with 12 wins, all 12 wins, coming by way of knockout. Here is the reigning and defending Commonwealth and WBC International Silver Lightweight Champion, Sam Mitch
Yeah, you can confirm this, but he must have one of the best knockout ratios in the world in world boxing.
134.12 for Sam Noakes.
He's 100% knockouts. He's trying to catch up with Artur Beterbiev. 12-0 with 12 knockouts. He's from Maidstone with hands of stone, Sam Noakes. And it's quite a streak, though, that he's gone on. But the guy he's got in front of him, Lewis Sylvester, will be trying to keep away, will be boxing, will be moving. And it's a stern challenge for Sam Noakes.
Absolutely. 12 rounds is a very long time, though. And that's the thing, like with the if they can cut the ring down properly, it makes it very, very hard, and you would assume that he's going to get him eventually.
Well, that's what he said at the press conference. He said 12
rounds. Once again, ladies
and
gentlemen, these two competing tomorrow night in a scheduled 12-round contest for the Commonwealth WBC International Silver Vacant British and Vacant WBO International Silver Lightweight Championship.
Straight in with a handshake there, Sam Noakes, but it will be all serious tomorrow night.
Sam lives in Maidstone, just a few miles away from where my wife, Louise, used to live in Isle of Sheppey. Oh, so, nice, got an affinity towards Sam Noakes.
So you'll be supporting him tomorrow night? Absolutely. In his bid to join you as a British champion, Nathan.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we are going to weigh in tomorrow night's main event participants. They will be competing in a scheduled 12-round contest. It will be for the WBC Silver and Commonwealth Middleweight Championships. First, we welcome to the scale the challenger from Clonoc Vale, Wales. He brings a professional record consisting of 25 wins, 4 defeats, 1 draw, 20 of his 25 wins coming by way of knockout. Let's welcome the former world title challenger, Liam the Machine Williams.
Well, I'll tell you what, Liam Williams has brought plenty with him here to this weigh-in. Former two-weight British champion, former world title challenger.
159 pounds for Liam Williams.
And bang on the weight, WBC silver and Commonwealth middleweight titles on the line.
And now we welcome to the scale the defending champion from Ilford, England, undefeated with 18 wins. 14 of his 18 wins coming by way of knockout. He is the reigning and defending WBC silver and Commonwealth middleweight champion, Hamzah Sheeraz.
Well, I'll tell you, this place just erupted. This felt like a Nathan Heaney fight night, the way this place has erupted here, Nathan.
159.4 for Hamzah Sheeraz.
Yeah, very good sports. Both lads got good sports.
How did he look to you on the scales there?
He looks good, yeah. He looks good. He's very tall.
Yeah, it says that he's 6'3" on box rank. I feel like he's taller than that, Nathan. What do you reckon?
6'4", 6'5", maybe.
Absolutely huge middleweight, but he's got an absolutely huge task in front of him tomorrow night. You can see Liam Williams there. He's ready. He's raring to go. He is the machine, 31 years old, and he believes that he is the wrong guy.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this our main event tomorrow night. 12-round schedule for the WBC Silver and Commonwealth Middleweight Championships.
I'm getting nervous myself. Good atmosphere, this.
Wow, absolutely tremendous atmosphere in here. And that is a tense face-off. Hamzah Sheeraz and Liam Williams ends with a handshake, but I tell you, they did not want to take their eyes off each other.